The bones of the skeletal system support the body and work with the muscles to help it move. Let's take a closer look at the internal structure of bones and bone tissue. The sectioned femur model in Human Anatomy Atlas 2022+ shows the two types of tissue found in long bones, spongy and compact. The ends, or epiphyses, of the femur consist of spongy bone surrounded by compact bone. The shaft of the femur, also called the diaphysis, consists mostly of compact bone. With the exception of its articular surfaces, the femur is surrounded by a layer of connective tissue called the periosteum. The periosteum contains progenitor cells that grow into osteoblasts, which are essential to bone growth and healing. The medullary cavity inside the femur is filled with yellow bone marrow, which consists mostly of fat. Now let's look at spongy bone in more detail by launching the osteon microanatomy model. Spongy bone has slender fibers, and its lamellae, or layers, form a reticular structure that looks kind of like a sponge, thus the name. In certain bones in the body, the spongy bone tissue contains red bone marrow, which produces red blood cells. The structure of compact bone looks quite different. It forms concentric layers around a central canal, or Haversian canal. The central canals contain the vasculature that supplies the bone's cells. Lacunae are tiny chambers around each central canal. They contain osteocytes, which are the mature form of osteoblasts. Osteocytes are the most numerous type of cell in mature bone tissue. When bone tissue is damaged, cells called osteoclasts remove dead bone tissue. Fibroblasts build a callus, and osteoblasts turn that callus into new bone tissue over time. Want to learn more about bones, bone tissue, and bone tissue repair? Visible Body Web Suite has all the 3D gross anatomy and microanatomy models you need, as well as physiology animations. Learn more at visiblebody.com/websuite.